Hello everyone. In this video I will show you how to use UTP1310S DC power supply in hashboard repair. Below I will introduce you to the materials and tools that will be used in repair progress. This is the UTP1310S DC power supply. Its maximum voltage is 30 volts, and the maximum current is 10 amperes. These are the cables that we need to use in the test. In this video, we mainly use this cable to test the voltage of the hash board. Multimeter, used to demonstrate how to test voltage. This is the S17 hash board we are going to use today. Double row cooling fan. We need to use it to dissipate heat for the hash board when testing the voltage. Okay, let's demonstrate. We start by energizing the UTP1310S DC power supply, then introduce its switching, and the regulation of voltage and current. Connect the power cord and turn on the switch button. Let's talk about the function and usage of these buttons in the hash board test. A button for adjusting the voltage. A button for adjusting the current. This is the negative terminal of the power supply output. Here is the positive terminal. Switch button. These are the main function keys in using the adjustable power supply. Now adjust the voltage. Since we use the S17 hash board for demonstration, the voltage we set must be consistent with the power output voltage of the S17 miner. The output voltage of the Antminer S17 is 18.5 volts, so the voltage is adjusted to 18.5 volts. When we adjust the voltage, press this button, and then until the digit to be adjusted is selected, rotate to the right to increase, and rotate to the left to decrease. Now adjust to 18.5V. In the hash board test, the current does not need to be adjusted, and the default value is 10 amperes. This is the switch. When testing the voltage, the switch needs to be pressed down, and the switch can be turned off after the test voltage is completed. Now connect the positive and negative cables. The black cable is connected to the negative. The red cable is connected to the positive. Alright, we're set up. Next, we demonstrate how to use this regulated power supply to test the hash board voltage. Set the multimeter to the DC voltage gear. Turn on the cooling fan. Connect the positive and negative poles of the UTP1310S DC power supply to the positive and negative poles of the hash board. We connect the negative first, then the positive. Now turn on the switch of the UTP1310S DC power supply. Let's test it now. Its power input shows 18.54 volts, which is the same voltage we set. Next, test the voltage of the booster circuit. When testing the voltage of the boost circuit, the black clip is still connected to the negative pole of the hash board, and the red clip needs to be clipped on the copper conductor behind the MOS tubes. Because when testing the voltage here, we did not use the test fixture to supply power to the hash board, so the PIC chip does not work, and the four MOS tubes will not be turned on. Therefore, it is necessary to cross the MOS tube and clip the red clip behind the MOS tube. The red test lead is connected to the positive pole of the capacitor, and the black test lead is connected to the negative pole of the capacitor. the multimeter shows about 23 volts, indicating that the booster circuit is normal. Below, we demonstrate how to test the LDO power supply. Here is the 1.8 volts power supply, and then here is the 0.8 volts power supply. Let's test the input and output voltage of the LDO 1.8 volts first. During the test, put the black test lead on the heat sink of the corresponding domain of the LDO, and measure the fourth pin of the LDO with the red test lead. The normal input voltage is about 6 volts. Measure its output voltage again. Its first pin is the output, and the normal output voltage is about 1.8 volts. You can see that the multimeter shows about 1.8 volts, indicating that it is normal. Next, test the input voltage and output voltage of 0.8 volts. The black test lead is also placed on the corresponding heat sink of the LDO, and the red test lead is placed on the first or third pin of the LDO. The test shows an input voltage around 3 volts, which means it's normal. Measure its output again. Its output is the fifth pin. The normal output value is around 0.8 volts. Finally, test the domain voltage of the S17 hash board. When testing the total domain voltage, the black test lead is placed on the heat sink of the last domain, that is the 12th domain. The red test lead is placed on the heat sink of the first domain, and the total domain voltage can be measured. And its domain voltage is 17 volts around. It is normal. There is also the test of the domain voltage between each other, that is the voltage between the two domains. The test shows around 1.5 volts, which means it's normal. Well, this is how the UTP1310S DC power supply is mainly used in repairing the hash board. When using the test fixture for the single board test of the S17 hash board, the test result shows zero. Using this power supply helps us to quickly find the fault chips, improve the efficiency and time of our repairs. Thank you all.